This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to another edition of Watch Me Work on Commander Sorsha. We're going to work today mostly on the staff here for the this really cool pike there, this pickaxe that she's got. And we're going to start things off here just laying down a nice base coat of gold. And then we'll come back in and put in a little wash and come in and work on some highlights. But for right now, just the base coat. That's all we want to do. And I notice I'm painting sort of against the grain. I mean, normally when you're painting a long staff like this, you would paint in the length direction. But because there are some details here that cross across that length, I've got to make sure I get into the cracks and the crevices, and so I'm painting in this direction instead. But either way, we're going to make sure the whole thing gets covered so that when we go to put our highlights on, there won't be anything that still has a lot of brown showing through. The brown just goes down as a good base color for the gold. Gold is difficult at best to paint over white, even more so to paint over black, but seems to work quite well over brown. So usually I use brown as my base coat for gold. Alright. Here we are. I'll probably have to lay down a couple of coats of this because it's somewhat thin. I put a little bit too much water in it. I admit it was my fault. And because of that, it's not covering quite as well as it should, or quite as well as it normally does, but it's not going to stop us from reaching our ultimate goal. And you can see I've skipped the area between the hands. That's because this particular brush will not work for such a small area. I'm sure that I could probably get into that area, but I don't really want to risk it. So, what I'll do is I'll paint these large areas on the outside of the hands first, and then switch to my double zero brush for the area on the inside of the hands. Alright, so there we go. Go ahead and rinse that brush out. Put a cap on it. And grab my double zero. And I'll just pick a little paint up here. And let's see here. There we are. Am I in frame? I'm in frame. That's exciting. Okay, so we'll just kind of work in this area here. A little bit there. And just gently work my way into these smaller areas of detail here. I've got to be a little bit careful with the staff. It's a very oddly pinned section, and so I don't want it breaking on me. I've had it bend a couple of times already, but I don't think it's going to break. Just in case, though, I would like to be very, very careful. Keep that possibility to a minimum. Now, I'm going to come back very quickly now and apply some nice long strokes going with the staff. Sort of flesh out some of these colors that are a little bit see-through. We've already got all of the cracks and the crevices painted by utilizing the brush strokes against the grain, so I'm just going to come back and kind of do an overarching, just sort of retouch with the color just to hit some of those areas that may not have been completely covered the first time. Alright. Okay. It's pretty good. There's a few little areas that Still not entirely covered, but they're covered enough so that I feel comfortable moving on to the highlight, which we'll do in a few moments. Alright. By the way, how's everybody out there doing? Hope you're doing well. It's a great day here. Thrilled to be home, thrilled to be working on some miniatures. And then we'll just touch a little bit here in the center. Probably don't need to get too much of this because with the smaller brush, I've already gotten most of it. I think we'll be all right. All right, now, rinse that brush out. And as that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and get my next color, which is going to be my shade color. And let's see, where is that located? That is right here. Okay. Shake this up real good. And just put some on the palette. Okay. I'm going to take the same larger brush I was using previously and just load it with this color. I'm going to thin it out a little bit though, I think. A little bit too murky. There we go. We'll go with it like this. The red will help kind of blend with the rest of the miniature. It's kind of a reddish tone that I'm going to be using for the shade here. Alright. And you see how that just sinks right into those cracks and crevices really, really nicely. Just provides some incredible shading. And it looks great on this gold. I've used this combination for years. I really like the way it turns out. Alright. We'll flip the piece over. Work down the underside as well. Make sure it's covered completely. It is. I'm just going to grab a little bit more of this. Go ahead and cover this upper portion of the staff. Closer to the head of the pick. Kind of going slow with this because I don't want any air bubbles to appear. It's one of the biggest drawbacks to using a wash or an ink of some kind is most of the time they're so thin that if you get them into any sort of textured area and you try to use them swiftly, they really end up creating a lot of air bubbles, which can create just a major, major hazard on your miniatures. It's just not fun to try and deal with, and it makes the model just a pain in the backside, to be honest with you. So I try to go slow when I use these things. Okay. I think there's a little bit left over here at the back. There it is. All right. There we go. Now, this particular wash takes a little while to dry, so I'm just going to let it sit for a bit. And once it's done, we'll come back in and we'll start highlighting this thing, rebase coating it with the previous color in certain areas, and then working our way up to a really nice shine for a highlight. The wash has now dried. I'm going to go ahead and come in and start applying our base coat once again, leaving the wash and crevices and the cracks it's sort of brought out so nicely. It's going to be a little bit more slow process than the first time I applied the base coat because obviously I've got to be much more careful this time. And so I'm utilizing my smaller brush and taking great care to avoid getting the color into any of the recessed areas. I do hope that I'm in frame. I am. Okay. I started painting without looking. Shame on me. This is so much easier when I do Let's Paints. It's always is easier with a second person, but that's all right. You know, there's a real fine line with metallic paints, actual metallic pigment paints, where it's, if you thin the paints out too much, they don't cover. But if you don't thin them out enough to where they do cover, a lot of times you end up glopping, and you end up with this, what essentially is textured paint on your miniature. So there's a very unique challenge that metallic paints present to painters, or to me at least. I don't know if any other painters experience these difficulties, but I imagine that they do. But I admit, I have difficulty with it. Sometimes great difficulty. And in years past, there were times when I just said the heck with it. I'm going to have what looks like gold mud caked all over my miniature because I don't feel like fooling with trying to get a smooth surface. I don't usually do that too much anymore. I've mellowed a little bit. There are those times when it just seems like the paint will not cooperate. And feels like it's just never gonna sort of lay down, thin out enough. But that's okay. Sometimes you just have to let the paint do what it wants to do. It's kind of like watercolor paint sometimes, you know? You can't force it. You've got to just let it flow. Let it do what it wants to do. It's not oil paint, so you can't always shove it where you want it to go. You just have to kind of finesse things. But I like the way this is looking so far. This is giving a good contrast to some of that red that we've already got on the miniature. I imagine that just this base coating step here will probably take up the remainder of this video, as it is a slow process. We shall see. Okay. All right. Add a little bit more water to the paints, kind of thickening on the palette. It's another thing about metallic paints is they tend to dry out much more swiftly than non-metallic paints. I assume it's because of the mother of pearl or the aluminum flake or whatever is used in that particular bottle to give the metallic effect. Adding that in instead of more painting medium probably makes it dry out more swiftly, but I don't know. That's my theory, but who knows? Okay, there we are. I really hope you guys are liking this series. This is a fun one for me. I had this model for years, and it just sort of sat in a drawer, and I was trying to think of something to paint other than a Games Workshop model, and I thought, you know what? I've got several Privateer Press minis that I've been meaning to get to, and this is one of the main ones. This one, and then an old Commandant Irusk miniature. It's no longer in production. I'm hesitant to paint that one because it's no longer in production. In some ways, I feel like I want to cast it first and paint the cast instead. That way I've always got a copy. But, I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. Okay, so I'm going to start, I guess I'll start here and be very gentle with this. A task that is not for people that can't draw a straight line. Really a difficult set of highlights here. And I get to do it about 4 times. That's going to be fun. That's all right. No complaints. I'm enjoying myself, and that's all that matters. All right. And the day you stop enjoying yourself, you need to just put the brush down for a while. Move to something else. If you don't enjoy what you're doing, you're just wasting your time. Not saying put it down forever, but you know, a temporary reprieve never hurt anybody. I know I myself went through a period where I just really, I just didn't feel like painting, and I went on for a year or longer. Finally got back into it, just kind of on a whim one day. Found that I really enjoyed myself, and that for the most part my skill had not diminished. And I don't think I've put paintbrush down since, not for more than maybe a week or so, and usually that's not because I don't enjoy it, but simply because I just don't have the time. Okay, I believe, well, there's still a little bit back here at the back. Just a hint. Alright, so we'll get these few areas and say a thankful prayer that I don't have to touch them again because they're on the underside of the mini, and pretty much nobody will ever see them, for the most part. Okay. There we go. Smooth that area out just a little bit. I think that will work. Push it on it with my thumb a little bit there. And then maybe a little bit with my little finger. Okay. Alright, I'm going to rinse my brush out for a moment. And let's see here. See if we can go ahead and finish up this next section before we end the video. We're running right up in that 18-minute mark. According to my calculations, I'm going to need to get some extra paint here. I think this next section, because there's not as much intricate stuff, will be a little easier to do. And then I may save the area between the hands for the next video. We'll see here. Let's just see kind of where we end up. All right, start with this big piece right here. Okay. In this area here in the center. If you're painting your miniatures, if you're newer to the hobby, you may experience a little phenomenon that I'm kind of having myself right here, trying to sort of keep myself from doing it, but there's a point on a miniature, or even on a section of a miniature like I've got here, where you are apt to speed up your painting because you see the end in sight and you want to get to that goal of finishing either the model or a section of the model. You tend to speed up the brush strokes, you tend to speed up the painting process, I do at least, and It's something that I will caution you against doing, because many times I've found when I do it, it's like you tend to sort of forget stuff, and you tend to make mistakes more easily that way. It's like, I don't know if you've ever done something like, I know when I was a child, my parents told me, you know, we're going to this particular place, and you've got, you know, a few minutes to get ready. And I would wait until the last moment and then try to get ready, and I found myself doing something like tying my shoes, and I tied my shoes 1,000 times before, but because I was trying to do it in a hurry, I just couldn't do it right. My fingers wouldn't cooperate. And I find it's sort of a similar phenomenon here with the miniature, in that even though I've done these brush strokes thousands and thousands and thousands of times before, if I speed up, I tend to mess up. And so I have to remind myself, as I come to the end of a section or come to the end of a model, I need to slow down, even though I want to get over or want to get over with or get it over with and be done with that goal, I still need to slow down. So this is the result of our quick little video here, and hopefully you've enjoyed it. Maybe you picked up a couple of tips, and you can kind of see where we're going with the model. I think it looks really nice with that gold there. That's going to be really beautiful once we're done. But next video, we'll actually come in and start highlighting the staff. And I think once we're done with that, we'll probably move into these the back of the cloak here. Maybe, I don't know, we may do the upper cloak in one video, and then the little gold backpack and shoulder gauntlets and things in another video. And I don't know, we'll see. But we'll get there eventually, but right now, I think we'll call it a video. So I thank you very, very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to drop those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Thank you very much again for watching. I really, really appreciate it. God bless you all. Have an outstanding rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.